Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening from wherever you're watching this video from. Welcome back to Two Wheels Paradise, your home of motorcycle content. My name, as usual, is Meshek, and here we are in a place called Ocean Soul in Karen. A very beautiful place. We're going to show you some very, very amazing stuff that these guys are doing in a moment. And today, I have a very beautiful friend with a very beautiful story. Can you see? Yes, I'm talking about Frida. We have been friends for a couple of years because of motorcycles. And that's why I'm hosting her today on this channel to give us her motorcycle story. Frida, karibu sana.
Asante sana, Meshek.
I know you never expected that.
I never expected that, but
we are friends.
Hi, everyone.
Uh-huh.
My name is Kagwiria Murungi. Most of you know me as Kagwiria Murungi.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know me by Frida. Meshek here. Well, what do I say about Meshek?
Meshek,
it's been a very long story. But yeah, this is me. Thanks for bringing me here.
Yeah, nice, nice. Yeah, the reason why we are here today is because you are a biker. A biker with a very long story, especially because you ride long distances. I know in the country where we live in, we don't have a lot of female motorcyclists who actually do adventure riding. Many of them are commuters. Here, there, on the highway, going to CBD, going for coffee, Java. But for you, you get lost in the bushes. Especially now, like a couple of months, you bought the KLR. And I think you are the only female rider in Kenya riding a KLR. So yours is just a complicated story. Yours is just something else. Yeah, so when did you start riding?
I started riding in 2021.
Mm-hmm.
That should have been around October 2021. I'm a little shy of 3 years into riding.
Mm-hmm.
That's when I started. I put a motorbike on the road. And it's very interesting how I got there. First of all, it's important, Meshek, to know that in our family, riding is not strange. My mother used to do it. So we grew up knowing about motorcycles. The shock for me was getting shocked that people get shocked when women ride. I had the privilege of growing up in a household where our father allowed us to experiment. All right. He never used to ride. He loved his bicycle,
mm-hmm.
not a motorbike, but he allowed my mom, he allowed us to experiment. So that is where this comes from.
So it is not starting with you.
No.
It has a history.
It does have a history. It does.
Very rare to find such cases. It's very rare, especially now, because when you talk about growing up, you got the chance to experiment. It should be not so soon, it's a couple of years, yeah. And those days, women riding, maybe one in a million.
Yes,
it was very rare.
Yes,
yeah. It, when we were growing up, motorcycles were very few.
Yes.
So finding a motorcycle in a village and also being ridden by a woman.
Yes.
That means something very, very special.
It does.
So it motivated you.
It did motivate me. This is the thing. I don't know about other people, but I usually hear people saying that they grew up and something in them led them to biking. For me, it has been second place. It's not something I came to a realization to, or I woke up and said, oh, now I want to get into biking. It was second place for me. It's the way you would do your everyday. It's one of those things that I always knew I was going to do.
Mm-hmm.
So it was not new for me. Actually, the disruptor for me was when I got out to what you call the real world.
Mm-hmm.
That's when I realized, oh my God, then I am sort of a misfit. So then the question becomes, then why didn't I get to riding sooner?
Uh-huh.
I didn't get into riding sooner because when I came out into the real world, real in quotes, I realized something in me, I don't know what, told me that I should change to fit.
You're trying to do what the society finds normal
and acceptable.
Like normal?
Yes.
And the motorcycles and women are not categorized as normal.
No.
So you had to change to fit.
Yes. I don't know what I did. I convinced myself that I needed to change to fit. And also, I don't know, for some reason, I convinced myself so that I become a wife and I become wife material, I needed to fit a certain mold. So
okay.
Those are some of the reasons why I didn't get into motorcycling sooner.
Because you're trying so hard to fit in the category of the marriageable women.
Yes.
Responsible. Yes. Like the way the society wants responsible.
Yes.
But later on you realize, no.
Oh, there are two categories of people in this life, Meshach. There are two types of people in this life. There are those who are just and they go with that.
Mm-hmm.
And then there are those of us who your body, your mind and soul will tell you you've veered off very far from who you are.
Rails.
Yes,
off
you're totally off the rails. Yeah. And I was totally off the rails and it showed. It showed and it became problematic. So at some point I was like, no.
I'm not going to do this again.
Yes, because from very early on, I was taught to show up in life as who I am, as exactly who I am.
Not who they expect.
Yes. So me adjusting to what society wants, that was learnt. That was not taught at home. That was learnt.
You know, in this life we live by learning, unlearning, and then relearning.
Relearning.
So at some point you had to unlearn whatever you had trained yourself.
Yes.
Constraining yourself, making yourself look like what the society wants.
Yes.
Denying yourself a chance to actually be happy.
Yes.
So you're living a life because I want them to see me living.
Yes.
Not because I want to feel I'm living.
Yes.
Okay, nice. So now, 2020. Now, here we come. Actually, we are in COVID season. Yes. What happened?
We were told the good president wakes up and says he's put... what was that? That we couldn't move in areas?
Oh, the cessation of movement.
Cessation of movement. There you go, big word. Then there was cessation of movement.
Yeah, you can't leave Nairobi, you can't leave Limuru, you can't...
Yes. So now here I am. I live in Limuru, Kembu County.
Mm-hmm.
And I am totally... There is totally cessation of movement. I can't leave home. I cannot go to work. I'm working from home.
Actually... You work in Nairobi.
Yes.
You live in Kiambu County.
I live in Kiambu
County. Then there is a border in between.
Then there's a border. Actually, the border was 1.5 kilometers from my gate.
Away from the gate, or you have to go through it?
I have to go through it, then access my gate. That is how close I was to cessation of movement.
That was close.
That was very close.
So you had to actually navigate that barrier every other day you want to get out of your house.
Yes, there was that. But then again, it was unnecessary. I was allowed to work from home.
Mm-hmm.
So there was no particular need to go against the cessation of movement. So, but then it presented other challenges. When there is cessation of movement, it forces you to be home.
Actually, it is pushing you to be home.
Yes.
Most of your friends, most of whatever you do, shopping and stuff, things that you should be doing within that locality that is closed, the closure is actually very close to your gate.
Yes.
So you can't really go far.
You cannot go far. And then... This is what I have to say about that cessation of movement. I think it affected a lot of us and a lot of families because, you know, what makes my generation different from whatever we consider Gen Z. By the way, I love Gen Z. They are going to change the world. They are very bold. They are not like us. They are very bold. They are not pretending. They are showing up. So I really love Gen Z. If they get to apply themselves, they will change the world. They are very different from us. But the advantage our generation has is that we had a third option in the sense that when it it's not work and it's not home, you had a third option. For some people, it's going to the pub. For some people, it's going to the gym. For some mm-hmm. people, it's going to Chama. For yeah, some people, it's going
to
church.
We have a lot of things to do.
Yes, there was a third option. Here we are, there's a cessation of movement. There is no third option.
Yeah.
Then it gives birth to home gyms, to Chama's online.
Ah.
So it spiked mental illness. That's why mental illness has become a pandemic. Because there is no third option. Tungeenda tucheze mpira, tungekutana na meshak to ride, but that has been curtailed. So that was the situation for me. I don't have a third option. I don't have an out. So it, like many others, you're forced to stay home.
And it is staying at home, and like real home.
Yes. And you're forced to face things that otherwise you would escape. And that brought its own complications. And I woke up one day and I remember Meshach and I said, I'm going back to who I am.
It's been so long. I have to go back now. Bikes, here we come.
Bikes, here we come. That was my first thing. And I remember I went to school and I rode into the home with a motorbike.
So you had to go through training.
I did.
Because this is something that many people ignore. For us who started riding bikes way back, we pretended that we know what we are doing. Because you got a 100cc in the village from a friend or a relative who does boda in the village, you can ride to town and come back, You tend to think, you know so much. I'm a rider, I'm qualified, get a good bike. But later on, you come to realize there is so much you don't know. And that is what makes riding dangerous for some people. But when you start to realize there is so much you don't know, the only option is go to school. Go, swallow your ego, like, just drop it. Go to class and learn how to ride a bike properly.
Yes.
I also had to go to class after almost 6 years.
Of riding?
Yeah, 6 years, on and off, like 6 years. I had to go to class.
And
learn the bad behaviors I had learned from, then learn the proper ones. And from that time, I stopped having issues with bikes.
Oh.
I stopped having issues with bikes. I'm very safe. Yeah. So I tend to think when you went to school to learn how to ride motorcycles, you started your bike life on a very safe platform.
Yes, I think I did, and I think I did not.
There is always that day made in hell. You just wake up with the water.
Always that.
You see, yeah.
So I did my basic training. And when I did my basic training, then I got out.
Mm-hmm.
Then I got my bike. I trained, then got the bike. But they were almost in quick tow of each other.
Mm.
The first day I removed the bike from the shop, I had my first accident.
Ah, put it down.
Of course, I put it down. It put me down.
Yeah. Somebody has to. Yeah. It happens.
It was the most hilarious thing, Meshach. You will never. If I tell this story and people can't believe it, I'm going up Gitaru, and on the left side, kuna kanta imepakiwa hapo. Not kanta, lori. Hizi kubwa imepakiwa hapo. And there was a bit of gravel there juu na walikuwa wanatengeneza barabara. So mimi nimekuja. My braking is, as in, I'm totally new. My basic training was...
Your riding is awful. Your braking is also awful.
My training was 4 days, if you can imagine.
Okay. That was short one.
So, nimekuja, nimeanguka. I hit the gravel. Nikaingia uko chini ya gari na bike. So, people have rushed from the stage. Gitaru hiyo ni stage ya matatu. People have rushed. Wanajaribu kuniokoa na mimi nimekatalia bike juni mpya.
Jesus Christ, what? So in your head you thought what I do, why did I? You can't take it away, but watch out, did I die? Am I? What? So you don't even care kama umeumia hiyo achana nayo.
I've paid a dear price for this bike. nimeilipia mdogo mdogo mpaka nimeimalizia.
Alafu nakuja naanguka hapa.
Nakuja naanguka.
Na nyinyi mnakuja kuniokoa. Are you genuinely helping me ama mnataka mchukue bike mliache ama?
Anyway,
that was hilarious.
Yeah,
it was tough.
Yeah, so after my basic training, I was not good at riding, not by a long shot. It took a dear friend who saw my riding, and he told me, "You all know Wakili." Wakili told me, "No, you'll have to go for advanced riding if you're to stay alive on the road."
What you're doing is not the correct way of riding.
Yes, he told me, "No, this will kill you faster than."
Yeah.
So, believe it or not, I did. I went back to school, believe it or not, for a whole year with Wasike. That's why me and my teacher Wasike, we are like
that's why you Wasike is a good guy. By the way, he's a good guy.
Yes. Can you imagine, Meshak? I didn't even know how to navigate the cones. I didn't even know you're supposed to brake fast and clutch. I used to clutch then brake.
When you crash, you put your bike into neutral mode. Then it starts accelerating using momentum. This is physics.
Lazima utaaguka. Yeah, now you're sounding like Wasike.
Lazima utaaguka.
So I go, Wakili directs me to Wasike. The first day, I'm going to the field. Everybody, kuna KTM 1290. You know Wasike and his. And me, I'm showing up, macho red, na zontes, 250. And I'm saying with my chest, I've come to learn advanced.
I'm going to learn advanced. I'm a biker, I want to learn advanced. Kifua juna,
I'm saying with my chest. Wasike tells me, go around the field, I see. I go around the field. Wasike walked up to me and asked me, is something wrong with your bike?
How does it look like it is wrong? It is still new.
So
the time now we start to realize someone is looking at me and I wanna.
So I'm very glad. If you know me, any chance I get to thank my teacher, I do. He did me a solid. For 1 year tulisumbuana, tukasumbuana for him to correct the very small mistakes. I'll tell you something extra, just a little bit. When you see me riding on my long rides, when I post, he's watching. Yes, usually see, he'll go through my posts, like when I've just gone to Homa Bay, he will see, and then he'll WhatsApp me and tell me, you're struggling with maybe your throttle, or you're struggling with your braking, Ivo. He'll see, because I told him, Mwalimu, utaniangalilia.
Yeah, you just keep an eye on.
Yes.
And actually, it makes you very safe.
It does.
It makes you very safe.
It really, really does.
Knowing that someone is actually watching you.
Yes.
And they are not shying off from correcting you.
Yes.
Because one of the biggest problems we have, ni kiburi. If you tell me I have taken that corner long, kiburi, how do you think you know me? See?
Yeah.
But now, when you submit to some authority from a trainer, tell you what you're doing, kidogo, correct this one, correct this. They are doing that to make you better, and it is all for you.
Yeah.
So when you accept to be corrected, it makes a lot of sense, and it makes you a safe person. Yeah, so now you have your zontes a whole year. Kwa kiwaja,
corn.
Ulipiga corn sana.
Iyo corn nilipiga karibu mwezi mmoja tunako sana na unajua Wasike is no nonsense.
I know
and
him.
The Meru in me cannot allow. So we've met, Wasike has met the Meru in me.
Ah.
And I'm like, ni pesa yangu inanisumbua hivi.
Yeah, so I'm paying you to harass me?
Harass me.
But you come to realize he's actually pushing you so hard. He's being laugh on you. Because he wants you to sink that into your head that you don't know so much, you're here to run. Yeah.
And it had to be that way because 4 months into riding, I almost lost my life on the road. Yes, that it was very serious. So we took it very seriously. My first, let me say, real accident, was nearly fatal. So it was important. So kama kulikuwa na any residual kiburi iliisha hiyo siku.
Yeah, iliisha
hiyo siku.
Yeah, kiburi inatoka.
Kiburi katoka. So yeah, I really submit to training and retraining. So yeah.
So you advocate day and night for training. Anybody who want to be on bikes, go for training.
Go for training. Yeah. When you upgrade, go for training.
Go for training. Yes. Yeah, when you change your bikes, try and...
Go for training.
Because, you see, the problems we have, and the reason why we have lost a lot of bikers, is because we change bikes, but we do not change our skills. We don't also change our riding gear. Mm. The way you started on a 200cc with that ship helmet from Nyamakema, it's the same way you want to continue riding a 1000cc 4 years later.
Yes.
So, see, you're changing your bike, but everything else that comes as a package in the name of riding is not changing.
Yes.
Some stuff are remaining constant,
but
the bike is advancing.
Yes.
Becomes dangerous.
Yes, and we also forget that change is both internal and external. So you might be a very good rider, but then the bypasses have been formed. More traffic volume, more riders. So if you started 13 years ago, there were less vehicles.
Yeah,
there were
less motorbikes. You cannot ride like you are 13 years.
Yes. Yeah. So the changes are both internal. So as much as you're changing your skill and your whatever, externally also things have significantly changed. The roads have changed. People have changed. Speed limits have changed. New structures have come up. So kidogo retraining matters. That's at least that's a very personal conviction.
Training on handling emergency situations.
There you go.
Because they are going to happen.
Yes.
You just take a corner so hard and then you realize there was a pickup truck. Broke down yesterday. Some drunk village driver left it there. They don't even care. I've been to Nyanza a lot of times, and Nyanza is one of the places you can die easily on a bike because of the sugarcane tractors. What? Hey! Piga kona ukiwa wa 20. Tractor diyo hii. Ili haribika jana asubuhi. Iko hapa. Especially Ahero Muhoroni. Coming the way. Hii barabara ya kutokea Rodiani. Iyo barabara. You can die very easily. Because of those jokes.
Don't we have stories?
Bobu sana. And actually we lost a guy on... when I was riding Benelli, we lost a guy on Benelli.
Oh.
A 302.
Oh.
Actually, alipiga corner usiku, around saa tatu, akapata hiyo tractor ya miwa. Iliharibika, ikawasha wapo. Yeah, he was crucified by the sugar cane. It was nasty. He died that night. So, that area of Muhoroni, Ahero, whatever, those. Yeah, it happens. But thank God we are still riding, and we pass through those roads every other time and we come back home.
I think the biggest shockers for me were riding in the rain, riding in the wind, riding in what? Oh, those are big shocks.
Unanyeshewa kama mifugo. And then you start remembering, mimi ni msichana. I'm female, bana. Isn't it hard? It's also like... What is this now?
I think...
How did I subscribe to this?
Paka, I usually ask people, has anybody else learnt the same way I've learnt? Because me ni me learn rough. Me ni me learn rough meshak. Ata my first rain gear. Mi kwa akili yangu ni menunua rain gear yenye inanito? Inanitosha. Siku nunua yenye iko snag. Sasa cha nikuambie meshak. Kunanyesha? Nimeingia Southern Bypass. Sema rain gear kuingia upepo ikakuwa parachute.
But now, inakuwa parachute. The nylon in that thing makes it like an air balloon. Hot air balloon. Oh God.
Meshak, so I'm fighting crosswinds to stay on the bike.
Sayo umefura hivi.
Sa ile kitu ikuambi kufura hivi juka bike ni kadogo imeficha paka side mirror. So sioni magari ziko.
Uwezi ona anything. Alafu the noise. Ni kama hizi roli za kubeba mattress imewekwa hema juu. See this? So hilarious stories. Inakutesa. People may look at you and think, you're having fun, how you share we? No. I'm struggling to remain upright. I'm actually struggling to remain upright.
Oh my Jacques. Watch out too. Please, there needs to be training on the right gear, especially for beginners.
Yeah.
We are struggling out here.
What do you wanna struggle?
Struggle.
Yeah.
But yeah. So that's my short biking life. It's been very interesting, I thank God.
You see, you have done a lot of long trips.
Yes.
To a point now, riding has become your life. Yes. It's not part of life, it is your life.
It is.
Because you're commuting to work on your motorcycle.
Yes.
Going back home, motorcycle.
Yes.
You want to go meet a friend somewhere, motorcycle.
Yes.
Weekends, I want to go, motorcycle. So the bike has become part of your life.
Yes, it has.
So now, when we got to know each other, you were riding the Zontes.
Yes.
What made you think about the KLR? Because now...
You're asking and you were there.
You see, I remember taking you to Moto ADV.
Yes.
But in my head, I never thought it was going to be a serious thing.
Oh.
Because I was looking at you and KLR.
Yes.
And then later on, it's almost 1 year later, you haven't bought the bike. You're just there. Yes. Kube, you had the plans.
Yes.
Frida.
The way I saw it in my head, I live in my head a lot. The way I saw it in my head, I was like, okay, I will start with the Zontes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now we call it ZT. I'll start with the ZT because I can harass it. It is not so expensive to maintain.
Mm.
Fuel pia itanitesa sana.
It's not even so powerful.
It's not so powerful. It's at all. Simzito.
You can handle it around and get
yes.
experience.
So nikajua hii, and it's what it is. Nasa hiyo nikianza, I don't know what I like. Sijui, mina sikia tu watu wakisema kuna sijui sport bike, sijui kuna adventure.
Why is a little hujui?
Najua tu kimasomo, but sijui applicability, na sijui roho yangu inapenda nini. So phase one, I was like, let me start with the ZT and what, it's shock, na lights zake, they are off, they are bad. So if you notice, and if the ZT, I really stretched it.
Mm.
Yeah, that's why people were saying it's the most famous cafe racer in Eastern Central Africa.
Yeah, yeah.
I really pushed it. Kwa mawe, kwa mchanga, just to get a feel, what is it that I like. And then, nikajua mimi, napenda sana off-road.
Napenda, away from the highway, you feel peaceful.
Yes, I feel very good. I want to be away.
Not so much speed, not so much shenanigans of overtaking here. But when you are off the highway, you feel peaceful.
I do. I really like it.
I think that's where I live. Mm. My hand looks like exactly that one.
Mm.
Very peaceful away from the highway.
Mm.
And most of the times even alone.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yes, and most of the places I like to visit are not on the highway either.
Yeah.
So that's when I reached out to you to kind of Moto ADV. And I remember at that point I didn't even know what I wanted. So nilikuwa nakusikiza mnasema do hiki.
A lot of KLR language.
So I sat on the KLR and I was like, yeah, this is it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then I went back home and really studied it. And I studied the other bikes that I really love, the African Twin, as I told you.
The CRF.
Uh-huh. So nikaiona. Well, nikasema, as a good middle point.
Let me take this one.
Let me take the pig.
It's a single cylinder.
Yes.
Not so powerful. Even the weight is there, but it can handle us. And again, KLR is a bike you can just handle the way you want. With very little experience in maintaining a bike, KLR is going to fit.
Yes.
When you go to the other side of the CRF, there is so much you need to know about maintaining that bike.
Yes.
So much you need to know. Frida, now. You are a mother.
Yes.
A mom.
Yes.
To a couple of kids.
Yes.
And you are also working in the corporate with a lot of responsibilities in your hands. How do you balance the life of being on bike, being in the office, very, very serious office, and being a mom to kids who are at their stage in life when they need so much attention?
Yes.
Teenagers. They need so much attention from a mother.
Yeah.
How does it work for you? Where is the balance? How do you navigate through this?
There is no balance. Oh, there's
nothing like balance.
There's no balance. There's none. There's no balance, my shark. At least for me. The way I see it is, if I have 10 buckets that all need my attention, I prioritize. So nikiona hii ndio iko, I bring it to the forefront. Ile zingine. So there's no
kuna darada hapo ati I'm here.
I tried that, it didn't work. And it doesn't work. What it does, it leaves you very tired and very bitter.
Frustrated.
Frustrated and burnt out. Yeah. And then that is number one. I learned very quickly how to move things around. And I had to learn that the hard way, because as well as you know, I had a very dark period over here. And it took a lot of help from therapy and counseling to get to understand a lot of these things. That is number one. I move my buckets around. So if I have travel, kids, work, I move them around according to what needs priority at that time.
Yeah, so you solve one at a time. You don't want to.
You
try mixing them and it's going to be trouble.
You don't even have the resources to be able to handle all of them.
You do this 10%, 6%, 8%, then by the end of the day, you are so tired, you have not accomplished anything, you are so frustrated, then you start getting bitter.
Yes, and then number two, delegate.
That is the part where most of us fail. Things cannot learn until I'm there. Now that's the attitude. Things will never learn unless I'm there.
Yeah, but
so even when you're traveling,
yes,
you are talking to some people on Kandol, trying to give instructions, trying to be there, trying to listen to meetings.
You must realize that perfectionism is the highest form of self-abuse.
Self-abuse.
Yes,
that's the word.
Yeah.
Self-abuse.
Yeah. So if you're a perfectionist, I was. It's the highest form of self-abuse, because then one, you never ever quite get time to be yourself. So I'll strictly talk as a mom and as a woman. I don't know about the male, but in my world I delegate. Just the same way in the corporate world, I have a team, a very capable team, and I delegate accordingly. It's the same way I do in my private life. As we've continuously talked, I told you one of the privileges I do have is my domestic manager here these days. You can't call them house girl.
The DMs.
So one of the privileges I do have is my domestic manager. She literally is a good team for me. And then I look for other like-minded people. There's a very good doctor called Dr. Mukolwe. Dr. Mukolwe does very good parenting classes in this Nairobi. I attended those parenting classes just because I needed help. I looked at my home and I saw I needed help. And part of that was forming a community around your children. Community meaning there are people who are inputting in your children even if you're not there. So that has worked really well in terms of disciplining my children, in terms of my house running,
Even for their motivation.
And I was listening to something today. I like reading a lot. Now it has been found that what determines if children will be successful, if children will have a better worldview, is the happiness of their mother.
Okay. The mother is the carrier of everything in that house.
Yes. So I strictly mimic for them the life that they would admire. And another thing that unfortunately as Africans we never get to do, wengi wetu huwa tunasema siwezi enda mbali juu wazazi watakaa na nani, sijui kama kwenu mko na hiyo, especially wazazi wakianza, unaanza kuona hatutaki kuenda mbali na mzazi. So most of us are anchored at home. So for my children, I tell them, have wings and fly. Don't look back. Your mom is okay.
Your mom gonna be fine.
Yes, your mom is okay. Yes, I tell and I do that by words and by my actions. Ata wakienda, like now they've been traveling for 2 months. They'll just call. They're like, mami uko, mami mwenda ku ride bike wapi? Ivo. They're sure I'm good. And they check in, and that's it. We give our children wings to fly, and we tell them the responsibility of us being whole is us, not them. And that is clear in my head. That go, your mom is going to be okay. Even when they're adults, go, experiment.
Yeah.
I'm going to be okay.
I don't want to peg my safety and my happiness on my children.
No.
I also don't want my parents and relatives to peg their own survival on me.
No.
Because that only means the one who is considered the source of hope stops living.
Yeah.
You'll stop living and start now helping other people live.
Yeah.
You're not living because your life has come to stop for you to serve the other people who are depending on you.
Yes.
So if as a mom you do that to your kids, you're stopping them from living.
Yes.
You want them around you, you want them to help you, you want them... It stops them from living.
Yes.
And so when you have that freedom in your head, you remain happy.
I do.
You have that comfort and peace of mind knowing that I have trained my kids to do this.
Yeah.
They can be safe wherever they are.
Yes.
They already know what values I advocate.
Yes.
They already know what mannerisms I portray at home.
Yeah.
They're going to do that wherever they are.
Or not.
Or not. They can choose.
They can choose. Mine is to kneel down every day and pray over them.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
To instill discipline. You know very well because my daughter came to you to have a talk.
Yeah, I remember I spent a day with her.
Yes. So that is what I do. And I usually pray to God to give me peace of mind that whatever it is that I've tried to teach and everybody else around them, that whatever has been taught has become convictions. If not, let me say one more thing. I know we've over-talked and overstayed on this topic. There's one very vital thing that I would want to bring to your attention and to the attention of the people who are watching us. My dad used to ask us, what is it that you've done wrong today?
Mm-hmm.
What that did, it eliminated the need to be perfect. Because when you go home every day and you ask your children, what did you do today? They tell you the good.
Mm-hmm.
And we go with that.
Yeah.
And we are happy. They say, ah, mom, tuliamka, tuka, na, 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 na. Mom, nilifanya homework, na nikapata zote. So in my house, I ask, ni nini mulifanya makosa leo? What did you do wrong today?
Mm-hmm.
So that it brings into sharp focus for them that they can fail and it's fine.
They have to understand that mom knows we go wrong.
Yes, and even for them, for themselves.
Yeah.
That they waleo waliamka, they tried, it didn't work. It brings up very balanced children. Unconventional.
Yeah. Because that doesn't always happen in many families.
Very unconventional. But if you know me, you know I'm unconventional. My children are homeschoolers for all you.
Yeah. Your life is a whole.
Don't listen to parenting advice from me. Yes. So, yeah.
But it's good. Eh? You have found the point where you feel comfortable.
Yes.
This is what matters in life. Because what I'm doing in my home, what I'm doing with my bike life, what I'm doing with my corporate life, we cannot always be the same. So you just do you and be you. Nice. So, the longest distance you have traveled on a motorcycle in one day?
In one day?
One day.
Oh, no, that's not... Oh, 407 kilometers, not much.
On which bike, the ZT or the KLR?
The KLR. 407. I'm not that rider who will... The way I plan out my journeys is I know my limits.
Mm-hmm.
I'm severely aware about my limits. And also, if you see for the group rides, if we've planned a group ride, I usually get out 2 days before or a day before.
Mm-hmm.
Because I know my capabilities. And I don't push beyond what is safe.
Because when you push yourself to prove something, You push yourself off the rails.
I do, and that is a very personal, that's a very personal choice. Mm-hmm. And I will answer this in the long way. Number one, I'm a parent. My cruise control is my children. So when I'm doing that, my cruise control is my children. So there is that. Number two, I'm planning to ride long term.
You want to be on the bikes for long?
For a while.
Yeah.
And with that, you start to realize some things. There's a limit where you push after, you start having a wear and tear in your body. Mm. Number three, I'm a much older woman.
Yeah.
There are things, and if I push beyond, they will determine how long I'm going to ride.
Yeah, your body will start suffering from wear and tear.
Yes.
At an accelerated rate.
Yes.
Because of the age, yes. Definitely.
Yes.
We are not going to be young forever.
Yes.
The moment you hit 40 and above,
yes,
you start now to slow down a lot of stuff. Because, yeah, I want to do it for long,
yeah,
let me do it slowly. I'm very sure I'm going to get there.
Yes, and you, yeah, you readjust.
Yeah.
So if all of us are going to Uganda, for example, mm-hmm, I'll get out 2 days before. Why not? In, mm-hmm, the end, I have my rest, I have my stop. So I'm not frustrating the other riders, neither are they frustrating me. We are all safe. So we have a meeting point, and then we continue to the place. As opposed to if I get off with them the same day, mm-hmm, probably they are younger, they have better reaction time, mm-hmm, they're able to go faster. So I push myself out of my safety zones. I don't like that.
Yeah, you're going to get yourself off the safety hook,
yeah,
and then start swinging all over.
Yes.
Swinging all over.
I start being in trouble.
Yeah,
very,
yeah, you're
fast.
Going to get into trouble. Yeah. Something I noted, if someone pushes you when you're riding and you get angry, you get yourself off the safety rails.
Very quickly.
Very, very quickly.
Yes.
And it can accelerate pretty quickly.
It can.
The same thing with you riding beyond what your body can accommodate.
Thank you.
And sometimes it's not even how your body reacts, is that specific day.
Yes.
You can wake up on the wrong side of whatever it is.
Yes.
The body did not feel like you rested enough yesterday, because maybe you were also riding, or you spent the day somewhere working.
Yes.
The body wakes up every day new, different.
Yes.
So when you wake up in the morning and you feel today if I do 400, I'm not gonna be safe.
Yes.
You lied until that point, you feel now this is enough.
Yes.
I need to find a place to rest, and there is tomorrow.
Yes, I also did a very good write-up in the end of 2023, because my inbox was filled by women who were asking me about riding and all that. And some of the things that I highlighted, I chose to highlight the very unique things that affect particularly a female rider, mm-hmm, all right? Leave alone the gender biases and whatnot, that somebody can deal with. But there are unique things when you're riding with a female rider we must be very cognizant about. Number one, our cycle is a very big one. Now, being a long distance rider, I learned that very fast. So for example, ukitoka hapa, ukitoka hapa when ufike Nakuru,
mm-hmm,
you see that weather, kuna kimende hapa katikati, kuna nini, ni baridi. When you hit Nakuru, kuko joto aje.
Mm-hmm.
Ukitoka Nakuru, ukiingia Timboroa Eldoret, hapa kuna nyesha mpaka hailstorms.
Yeah.
Ukitoka Eldoret, unaingia Eldoret, is windy and cold.
Yeah.
By the time you are coming from Eldoret, unaingia Kisumu, then you find where Jezebel hangs her bra there. Yeah. Na joto.
Uko sasa.
Yeah.
Uko diyo kila kitu.
So, our cycles are affected by that. So, you left Nairobi, you have no cycle, you get to Kisumu.
Uh-huh.
So, your body reacts.
Your body actually responds.
Yes, very differently.
You know some of these things, sisi, wanaume hatuwezi jua?
Yes. Na sasa tukiride na...
sasa tukiride. We only sweat and we like... okay.
Tukiride na male bikers, these are some of the things we cannot be able to explain. Number two, kama ride imekwa, when your cycle is on, we become thirstier. You are supposed to take a little bit more water when you're on your cycle.
Otherwise, you get dehydrated.
You get dehydrated very
when
fast.
You get dehydrated, you get fatigue.
Yes.
Headache.
Yes. So male riders will not understand why you need more rest stops.
And you cannot explain.
And you cannot explain why you need, or you can explain depending on what the company is. Now, here you are, you have your cycle. You need more rest stops because you need to change. Number two, you're taking in more water, so you need to visit the washroom.
and you can't just do it anywhere.
People will get frustrated because you have to really stop.
Petrol station in gear done.
Yes. Now, number three, that's the other thing. Once you're a long distance female rider, you very quickly learn you're safer with the bush than the community toilets. You pick up an infection like this.
And then it becomes disaster.
It becomes disastrous.
You guys are...
Yes, long distance female riders, respect them. Those are the unique things. So when you, ukiona, we are better off with a bush. It's cleaner, it's whatever, than a petrol station toilet or a hotel toilet. You pick an infection very fast. Now, when we are riding together and we are riding in the rain, there is nothing that bacteria loves more than cycle, warmth, and rain. And you know your gear is good.
You are incubating some bacteria and you're going to pay for this. Definitely you're going to pay for this.
So unatoka hapa, for example, let me give a very good example. Distance ya wapi. Unatoka hapa, unaingia Makutano. Kama unaenda Meru. Unaenda unapata mvua iko Makutano, unasema kama vile bikers say, sema hii iko hapa tu.
Iko hapa tu. Let us push to ipite.
My friend. Hiyo mvua inakupiga kutoka Makutano mpaka Meru town ndani.
Unapita ni kumbu. Inaitwa
ngobo. Na sasa
bado unanyeshewa.
Na sasa ile kitu imekuambia kwa kilomita juu akili uwakaje ukiwa kwa barabara. Hasa kuna mahali unafika unasema saa juu nimenyeshewa.
What is that to say? Nini na same twende.
So those are the alafu. That is number four. And I hope this comes out clearly, not as hindrances, but just some of the unique challenges we would face, especially as long distance female riders. And then there is the issue of there are women who are riding when they're perimenopausal. There are women who are riding when they're menopausal. I remember Wamoyo did a whole thing, and that is a whole other monster.
Yeah.
So... for female riders, there's quite a bit that goes on there.
For us men, most of the times is just sit on the bike, fuel it, and go.
Yes.
Very, very rare you find me carrying extra clothes to change. I don't even carry them. I don't know for what reason, but I even if I'm going to spend some nights, I don't. So you find that we don't have a lot of hassle.
Yeah.
And maybe I'm expecting you to also behave the same.
Yes.
But your body cannot accommodate this nonsense.
No.
It cannot.
It cannot.
And if you push it to accommodate this nonsense,
you'll pay for it.
You're going to pay for it.
Yes, especially if you're doing long distance. Say, for example, one journey you want to cover 2,000 kilometers. You know, it's one thing to say you're going to Mombasa, it's around 482 kilometers. Yeah. It's a whole different thing to say you're covering even 1,000.
That's a lot.
It's quite a lot.
It's quite a lot.
Yeah.
And I came to understand it's quite a lot at the time I went to Malindi, Nalombi, through Mombasa Highway to Mombasa, then Kilifi to Malindi, 2 days around Malindi, Mombasa, Malindi, all over the beaches. And then the third day, back to Nalombi through Ukambani. I did quite a journey, and on my way back home, I got to around Thika, because I didn't come from Mombasa Road, I came from the Ukambani side, yeah. Garissa Road. Around Thika, it's around 4 p.m. and I'm sleeping while riding. Little sleeping. It dawned on me, I think you have overstretched your limits. These limits are already overstretched and it is no longer safe. And actually, I was supposed to go and spend the night in Nyeri. I did not. I had to turn around, go back to my Nalombi house, just go and sleep. Go and sleep, because from this point going forward, you don't feel safe, you don't even look safe to everyone who is watching you, because what you are doing is not normal riding. So I understand when you're saying for female riders, your hormones and stuff like that, there is so much going on in your body and also in your head. There is so much going on even in your head.
Yes.
And it can become a disaster if you don't manage it.
Yes, it can. And for all the women who want to do long distance riding, don't be scared about it. Anybody can do it.
You only need to learn how your body reacts.
Yes, and also part of your safety gear. There's a lot of add-ons that you have to know. Mm-hmm. And there's some other mannerisms you have to acquire. For example, you have to always dry your gear when you get to the destination. Because then again, as I've told you, it's a breeding place for bacteria.
Incubation can happen.
Yes, these days they've come up with wonderful things. We have disposable underwear. So that's a really big one. So that is something you can carry.
You don't want to ride from Nalombi to Makueni. Mm. You got Lindon around Emari. Mm. By around Kibwezi, you got it's sunny over there. Mm. You're starting to dry from outside. Mm. Then you proceed to Mombasa. Mm. You just go take a shower, clean your underwears, and then... it is very hot here. We want to be wet.
You will land into trouble.
Yeah, you're going to pay for it.
You're going to pay
for
it.
There's always a price for that.
There is. And more so if you're riding with bikers who like camping, you cannot...
the issue of sleeping outside in tents.
Yes. You cannot hang your privates on top of the tent. So there's quite a bit of female riders.
There is so much. Yeah. But for you, you have navigated those roots and now you understand yourself.
I do.
You understand yourself.
I do.
And now that makes you very comfortable. You can ride with a group, just one friend, alone. Yes. You can just do it.
Yes.
Tell me about your Nyanza trip.
Yes.
I saw videos that were looking good. Umeteseka?
So,
you're not. And it was actually after the Ololokwe.
It was after Ololokwe. I've actually done 26 counties now. The only difference is I had not been documenting. So my very good friend Abdi Zeila, when he met me in Uganda, he was like, why don't you document this? You cannot believe I've done 26 counties and not going through them. Yes, I go, I sit, I
you
camp.
You get into interiors
yes,
of the county?
Yes, I have Kisumu County, Makueni, Machakos, call it. Yes, so the only regions, the only counties I've not visited are the larger north and coast. And coast I've put it pending and because that is home. And also Mount Kenya, I've not done Mount Kenya because that is home also. I want to give it the attention that it deserves. So yes, I've done 26 counties visiting, not passing through. Really visiting. I've just
you
not documented.
Done a lot of riding.
So I'm in the process of trying to document that. I don't know. I've not figured it out. Not a content creator. This is when I'm just learning about how to do this. So it's still taking shape. God knows what that will become. But the Nyanza trip, as you asked. It was part of closing out the Western Circuit because I finished the Western Circuit. And I was like, okay. So here we are. It was the second time I was taking KLR on a very long trip. So first time was Ololokwe, just to get a feel of
a
group ride, to get a feel of how it handles, and also I was supporting my brother Deno to do his maiden ride and launching his motorcycle adventures company. So I was supporting him for that. So I wanted to feel how the KLR handles. It was my first time with a KLR on Fesh Fesh.
Yeah.
Well. That was a whole other thing that will need a whole other video, but anyway. So Nyanza, it was after Samburu. Then did some things with Wasike to correct some things. So the Nyanza one, I was like, let me go and wring the neck of this KLR and see to what extent it can. I don't overplan my trips.
You don't want to prepare like a whole government budget, like sitting down and writing the procedures.
I just know.
It makes the trip actually less attractive.
Yeah.
When you plan so much.
Yeah.
Yeah, I also learned that when you plan so much, it makes the trip not attractive.
So
sometimes you just slide through. Yeah. Just go.
So mine will just be, I'll look, I'll like, what historical sites are there? What are the art things that are there? Because that's my liking.
Art.
I do.
Mm-hmm.
So we just go. I just go. And this is exactly what I did. Nilirai, nilijua day one, nataka kufika Homa Bay kwa lake. Because
mm-hmm.
I wanted to see the sunset. Road, kufika Kisii County, bikers woko Kisii County, like at Yapana. So nika ingia Kisii. Kachokona Kisii.
Why?
Kachokona Kisii. Nikatoka Kisii, nikaenda nikafika Homa Bay. So this is what I do. And people are free to give me opinions of how I can do it better. But this is how I do it. Nilienda, nafika Homa Bay. Fika Homa Bay, naendanga kwa the next kibanda ya boda. Na wauliza, hapa ndiyo Homa Bay. Nanda niambia madam umefika. Naambia sasa, kutoka hapa, nataka munionyeshe lake iko upande gani na munipeleke hapo. So they take me there. They are usually very happy to do
it. Yeah, actually, that's something I wanted to ask you. How fast do you make friends? Because I look at what you post online and I'm like, okay, I've been riding for so many years, but Frida has something different. You make friends so fast. You make friends so fast. I saw you, Bukichagua,
inaitwa Fulu Wiu. Sasa acha nikwambie.
You do a lot of stuff.
It is God's favor, and I told you. Mimi, siyezi nikakwambia kuna formula, it's God's favor. I was taught, wake up in the morning, pray for favor, before God and before man. And I set go. So nilienda, hey, mimi, watu wa Homa, mekaribu animalize. Izo samaki tulienda kutega usiku.
Huh?
Samaki inategwa usiku.
So you also took part in kuenda kuzitafuta?
Iko haja gani. So
ne
unapanda boti, but this was the thing.
Mm.
Wao wanaenda, wanatega usiku, wanazingoja throughout the night. I couldn't.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Because I was also not feeling a bit safe in the lake. Mm. So tukaenda, nikaona vile uwa wanatega, then mi nikaregeshwa. So what you were seeing is the following day in the morning, kama wamezileta. So tunaziosha.
Okay, now this looking good.
Yeah, so that was that.
Yeah? You have a very good story, and see, you are an engineer.
Yes.
A mom. Someone with the responsibilities in the society. Society expects you to live and act in some way.
Yes.
And here you are, leaving your kids at home, picking your bike, and just go. Do you have any fears when you leave? Sometimes will I find them safe when I come back? Like, or what you told me earlier on, that you have given them wings to fly, gives you peace of mind. You know, wherever they are safe.
Oh no, you're always in constant fear. You have
so it is still keeping you conscious.
Oh yes. Constantly. Giving them wings to fly and whatnot does not remove the fear.
As a mother, you must keep remembering I have kids.
Constantly. I constantly am in fear. Every time I get on that bike, I'm like, whoa.
Mm.
You know? If you had the privilege to film me at home, you would be very shocked. In the morning, they're the ones who prep the bike. Even for my long distances, they're the ones who prep the bike. And they will gather around the bike. I have photos, maybe you can share.
Huh?
Yes, they'll gather around the bike, including my house girl. And they will give me a hug and they'll pray over me. I'll send you, images.
You have a team.
I have a
that
team.
That is always behind you.
Yes, and I'm constantly in fear. I'm constantly in fear of, will I come back home? And when I'm having discussions with them, I tell them, there's always the possibility I'm going to go that way and not come back. It's a very open discussion in the house. Also, I will tell you this, Meshak. Mm. I'll give you an example of when I was going for the Homa Bay trip. When I got to Mbita, my mom had called me in the morning. It's like, you're traveling? I'm like, yes, mommy, not travel. And then be a pole pole.
Yeah.
And then she'll be, nilipofika hapo kwa stage, nasikia simu yangu ikilia. So I engage the kado. Ananiambia uko kwa barabara, weka pikipiki kando. So ndakutumia hiyo image, niko kwa stage, anasema tufanye video call. So when I do a video call, you see all of them in the screen. You see my mom, my children, my house girl, my nephews, they are there, they are cheering me on. So they say, go, go, go.
Then you don't have a choice. You just have to ride. You don't have a choice.
So
you have a whole stadium of spectators.
So I'm really supported in my riding. I am really supported.
It makes a lot of sense. And thank you so much for even taking time to share this. So what would you want to tell someone who is going to watch this and want to ask, I'm a woman. In my 40s, in my 50s, I have felt like I have lived life, but there's something missing. Should I choose bike to fill that gap? What would you tell such a person?
Go for it. Go for it. It doesn't have to be biking, but anything. Live unapologetically and age disgracefully.
Hakuna was doing any.
Age disgracefully.
Kuja nyumbani ukiwa na vumbi.
I come home dirtier than my kids.
Like for a season like this one, it's just like about today. We're gonna get rained on going back wherever we came from.
I get home dirtier than my children.
And you're happy.
I am happy. I am very happy. This is the other thing that really curtails us from moving forward. We have a death mentality as a human.
Yeah.
We retire, we die. You get to a certain age, mtu anasema, aki nimefika hii miaka nimefika nitaweza. We die even before we die.
Yeah.
Don't. And you will find your tribe. I know the various issues we find that I will not find somebody to date me. I'll not find somebody to marry me. I'll not find... You will get.
They are there.
Oh.
Just get a bike. You'll find them.
If biking is your thing, go for it.
Just go there. You'll find them there.
You will... Or they'll find you.
They'll find you.
Or they'll
someone
find
will
you.
Find someone.
Yes. I think if you shift focus to yourself...
Mm-hmm.
Not to yourself. That's a bit selfish. If you shift focus for the God-given purpose...
Mm-hmm.
That you came to this earth to do and live authentically, you find your tribe. They'll be drawn by your...
You're going to attract what you're doing. You're going to attract what you have from inside.
Yes. You will not miss, however, the continuous banter. I don't know about other female riders, but I get it daily.
People telling you, just be a woman.
Oh, people tell
Leave
me.
Leave your age.
People exercise their liberties to tell me what they want.
They try to punch you.
Oh, they do. Every day. Every single day.
When living like a teenager, you just, you're an old woman.
Yes, you're an old woman. You have kids who behaves like this. When will you ever slow down?
When will
you ever mature? And for me, who
they
is...
keep pushing you.
And for me, who is the way I am, when I get... potential partners, they ask me all manner of questions.
And then you mention bike and by what?
Actually, they see me on the bike and they're like, ati ii utaacha mwaka gani? I'm like...
So if we get into this, I have to stop this.
And then the next question is, what then will you do with my kids? Because they ride also.
Yeah, so what are you going to do? Because it is now in the blood. So, come on.
So I'm imagining Casey nyumbani. Well, umekuja mesha kunasema uyu BBC mzuri. You meet my mom and the other people and we are all looking at you and they're wondering.
The heck are you talking about? You just came to the wrong compound because this is the wrong compound. Oh God. This is the wrong compound. Yeah.
Because my brother, his wife, they ride.
And these people are your spectators and your supporters.
Yes.
Then someone is trying to report you to them. Like, anakibia sana, anaenda sana.
No, but also we are not, si ati hatuna akili mesha. Leo nikiolewa na niko na kwangu. Do you seriously think, naweza amuka tu any weekend niende?
Hey.
No.
utakuwa unafanya planning yako ya whatever it is, you have to plan, yeah, utafanya plan. Like for us, like for me, I'm married, I have kids. Even when I'm out there on my bike, I always have the thought of my family. My family. When people are spending their night out and stuff, like I remember, there are some couple of kids who expect to see me in the evening coming back home. So if you see me leaving the party earlier, it's because there's another gang that is waiting for me.
Yeah.
And they have to see me.
Yeah.
I have to show up for them.
You have
but
to.
That doesn't mean I have to choose them over the bike or bike over them.
No.
Because the moment there is a choice between me or the bike, that's the moment you lost me.
Mm.
You lose me the moment there is a choice.
Mm.
Yeah. The moment there is this versus this, just choose the other one. Forget about me. choose the other one. It's gonna be better for just choose. Yeah, it's actually true.
It's a very easy dilemma.
Yeah, when
really.
Someone tells you, I want to date you, Frida, and you learned, you're beautiful, you're ABCD, I want, but the bike, come on.
But what
if if the bike is coming in the way, so let's just bring the bike to my side.
But what is the headache though when there are people who don't ride?
Yes, just go choose. That's what I'm saying. If there is a choice between me or the bike, just choose the other option. You already lost me. Thank you so much, Frida.
Thank you, Meshack, for having me. This was fun.
Been planning this for a while now.
Yeah, oh yes.
But God's time is always the best.
Always.
And we got accommodated by very beautiful people here.
Yes.
Ocean Soul. And they are making very, very incredible stuff.
Yes.
I have learned that you love art.
I do.
So I'm going to try and see what trip we can take.
Yes.
Somewhere there is art. I'm going to be keen now to find those art facilities.
Yes.
And then recommend to you because, because I understand now
yes.
you love art.
I do.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thanks for having me. This was fun.
It's been a good day.
Yes, I don't do well with interviews. I don't, but this was really easy. Because I look weird. And then, you know, I'm at that age where I'm like...
Thank you so much for taking your time to be here up to this point. It's an incredible interview with a very good friend. See you around, see you next time, and God be with you. As I always say, your safety starts with you. So stay safe. To who is paradise, my name is Meshack. Goodbye.